Tuesday night, 9 o'clock, yeah. And while Tom Sharpling is holding it down over on The Best Show, I'm right here with you on the other Best Show, HQ, on this first unofficial day of summer, welcoming you to the summer of HQ. It's going to be big fun, a lot of sun, and a bus full of nuns. Yeah, they're on their way to the 12th Annual East Coast Nun Con in Nutley, New Jersey. And I'm calling all aboard the Trivia Train to Trivia Town. We truly have a special summer lineup for HQ's. New features, record prizes, special guests, new games, maybe a new summer hour? No summer hours? If you're going to camp, take HQ with you. Play with your bunkmates. It's perfect for evening activities. Get Keith the Waterfront Director into it. He'll love it. I think he'll like me. Okay. I'm your host, repping the East Coast with those nuns. Quizzy Stradlin, Quiz Quistofferson, Father John Quisty, Scott Rogowski, live from the greatest city on earth, the city that never sleeps, Newbridge Canyon, New Jersey, canceling Roseanne, with all 760,000 plus of you, including Audrey, Jeff, and Ellie Spiegel, Kelly Fisher, the FBCWA High School Camp in Myrtle Beach, the Jacobs family, Landy 1121 and Bowling Ref on their anniversary, Shayna and Tomer on their matrimony, Mazel Tov, and Queen Judith, the patriarch of the Warner family with a birthday, and Coco with a birthday. Answer 12 questions, win real cash money. Tonight's prize is 5,000 Dolph Shays, 5,000 Danny Shays. That's what's known as Mad Stacks. That's a lot of money. When I was 18 or older and I had to babysit every weekend for 4 years to make $5,000. Now young adults today can just go on their phone and make a cool 5Gs in 15 minutes. Tisk, tisk. If this is your first time playing, let me give you a pro tip. Trust your gut. And if you're playing with friends, may the 29th be with you, HQDs, as we get down to the nitty-gritty with over 800,000 of you on this Tuesday evening. Let's get the show on the road. Cumero numero uno. A carbonated beverage is colloquially called what? Soda, Yoda, or Hoda Kotb? Colloquially. Hoda Kotb might be a tall drink of water, but to cool down on a hot summer day, you're better off reaching for the most refreshing way to rot your teeth. Soda. S-O-D-A, soda. Some of you call it pop, soda pop, pop soda, sody. Whatever you call it, it's the answer. 801,939 of you had the answer at Q1, but they start easy. Q2, which of these is the name of a 19th century U.S. political party? Dress, ponce, or wig? I know what you're all wondering. Did the members of the Whig Party wear wigs? Was the political scene in mid-1800s America a literal Whig Party? Sadly, no. The name comes from an old British word, wigamore, meaning cattle driver. Anyway, the answer is wig. Now, you gentlemen going to buy some wigs, or ain't you? 704,520 are buying that question for a dollar. Getting Q3. Which occupation specializes in pregnancy, birth, and women's reproductive health? Midwife, full wife, or half wife? Now, this person, usually a woman, is trained to help other women along their baby-making journeys, from pregnancy to labor and postpartum, offering care and support along the way. Midwife is the answer here. Are there male midwives? Yes, there are. What do you call them? Midwives. 686,330 are in the middle of the night, walking in their sleep to Q4. If a basketball player in the act of shooting, they receive what? Assists, free throws, or a walk? In the middle of the... I was walking in the... in the middle of the wife. Midwife. That's where my brain was going. You get fouled while taking a shot. You get two of these. Unless you're attempting a three-pointer, then you get three of these. Or if you're fouled and you make the shot, then it's only one. You know what? Just watch a game, you'll get it. They're called free throws.
And there it is. Yeah.
Free throws, free throws, free throws, free throws. And a big basketball series is coming up. The NBA Finals, a perfect way to get into basketball. 658,953 are dribbling on nothing but net to Q5. The illegal practice of record companies secretly paying radio stations to play songs is known as what? Payola, beat bribe, or money music. Yeah, no, they're secretly paying radio stations, not paying payola, to play.
not playing to pay, not praying anything away. In the days before your phone told you what to listen to, people actually listen to the radio to shape their musical tastes. You can understand the temptation for record companies then to slip a few bucks under the table in exchange for airtime. That's illegal, and it's called payola. C. Alan Freed. Ooh, ouchie, wowie. 216,234 answering the question, who charted? You did on this Q5. You guys are heat seekers, but we did lose about 400,000 out of you there. Slightly savage. Q6, what type of dog is most commonly trained and used by guide dogs of America? Rottweiler, Labrador Retriever, or Border Collie? Now, these pup-pups are the chosen ones to do the important work of helping to guide the legally blind, and I think we can all agree, the fluffier, the better. Labrador Retriever is your answer. Who's a good answer? Who's a good answer? 200,635 of you. Well, I'm going to be guiding you to Q7. You know your dog. Do you know your swimming? If a swimmer is caught in ocean rip current, which is the safest direction to swim first? Against the current, toward the shore, or parallel to the shore? Whatever you do, don't swim towards the Jersey Shore.
God.
And stay away from Pauly Shore, okay? Swimming against the current will just tire you out. So even though it's scary, the best advice is to let the tide take you and then calmly swim parallel to the shore. Don't freak out, man. Play it cool and swim parallel. 182,269. You haven't sunk yet. You're getting Q8, The Secret Life of Alex Mack, aired on the same network as which other show? Lizzie McGuire, Powerpuff Girls, or Zoe 101? And before The Secret Life of Pets, there was Alex Mack. Just another average kid until her first day of junior high. One minute she was walking home. Next there's a crash and she was drenched in some weird chemicals. So typical of today's teens. And while there was no magic to be found on Zoe 101, it was magical, the fact that they shared the same network. Yeah, both on Nickelodeon. That's magic to 60,568 of you who are melting into a pool of fluids, sliding under the door to Q9 like Alex Mack. Which of these units is named for a British scientist? Joule, volt, or ampere?
Joule, I'm pretty
sure. Joule, volt, ampere, ampere, depending on the pronunciation guide you go by. These are all very hard to explain measurements for electric potential or electric currents. I'm not going to get into it. I'm not a physicist, but I will tell you, James Prescott Joule was a physicist, a British physicist and mathematician, and he has the unit of energy named after him. 43,031 of you are amped up for Q10. Which of these classic hip-hop songs explicitly mentions brunch? Cream, gin and juice, or juicy? Brunch? Rapping about brunch? Does cash rule everything around you? Are you sipping on gin and juice? Or are you feeling juicy? Only one hip-hop legend rapped about lunches, brunches, interviews by the pool, and was considered a fool because he dropped out of high school. It's the N-O-T-O-R-I-O-U-S. You just lay down slow. Biggie, who wrote Juicy? Do, and if you don't know, 13,234 of you knew it. We did lose about 30,000. Brutal Q10. Q11 right now, folks. According to World Atlas, the capital city with the lowest average temperature is located in which country? Mongolia, Greenland, or Russia? You've come so far and got so far. In the end, it doesn't really matter if you don't answer this one right and then the next one. Even though Moscow, Russia, and Nuke Greenland can get pretty darn chilly. Yeah, the capital of Greenland is Nuke. I do it all for the Nukie. Mongolia's capital, Ulaanbaatar, or Ulaanbaatar, depending on your pronunciation guide, has average temps of negative 1.3 degrees Celsius, and I'm seeing our first bona fide savage question of the night. Ooh, talk about freezing. Over 10,000, you just got frozen out of the quiz. You're gone. You fell in those icy cracks. Goodbye. But 3,529 are still standing for the final round tonight. Well, it all boils down to this, and it better be right now. Ulaanbaatar, it's freezing cold. You gotta stay hot for Q12. Which new feature caused Mark Zuckerberg to write a Facebook post telling users to calm down? Facebook chat, newsfeed, or the like button?
Newsfeed.
In 2006, coinciding with his decision to open the site to all users, not just university students, a.k.a. the worst decision Mark Zuckerberg ever made. Facebook used to be fun, guys. I remember that time. This new feature also proved unpopular and still pisses users off today. Zuck told us to calm down and smoke meats about the news feed. Yes, that annoying news feed at 1,993 are our winners tonight.
Did you get that?
I don't know.
Are you smoking meats? Did you get your brisket? You smoking your brisket? Your pork ribs? You doing it? You did it! You won HQ! All 1,993 of you. 1993. A very good year. That's $2.51. So a whole lot, including CeCe Mills, Craig Newcomb, Jennifer Holmes, Shaq Tiki, Beachhead Ted, Rez Mataz 95, Sea Turtle 3, Turtle, KM Washi 2, Animator 78, Catan 22, Cobra 99, and Gray 06, and a whole lot more of you. $2.50. How about that, folks? You did it. You slayed the dragon. You won HQ. You got a little bit of change and bragging rights for all eternity. Go yell it from the mountaintop. Tweet about it. And join us again tomorrow. All of you. 3 p.m. and 9 p.m. Eastern Time. That's right. We're back. Back in the HQ groove every weekday. 3 p.m. and 9 p.m. Eastern. Until then, I'm Scott Rogowski signing off, congratulating the Golden State Warriors for joining the Cavaliers of Cleveland in the 2018 NBA Finals. Going to be a very exciting matchup. And as my friend Jason Gay tweeted, this will be the first Warriors-Cavs NBA Finals since 2017 and only the fourth since 2015. Good night.